Thank you so much for tuning in. We are coming to you from Oracle Television Network. Today we have a wonderful program. We have in the studio together with me is the doctor himself, Reverend Francis Oracle. How are you today?
I am blessed.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
And today we are expositioning a book called The 21 Curses That Every Kenyan Must Break.
Right.
Tell us, how did you come up with this topic? Did God give you a revelation or how?
Thank you very much. What actually happened, I heard the voice of God. When I came to the ministry, that
yes.
is almost 20 years ago,
uh-huh.
when I looked at the congregation I was ministering to,
yes.
at that time it was a crowd that, or a congregation that had no future,
yes.
they had no hope.
Yes.
And their lifestyle was below the normal lifestyle.
Yes.
And that is when God spoke to me and said, I want you to lift up these people.
Yes.
From where they are to where I want them to be.
Uh-huh.
And the signal.
Yeah.
And the word that I heard that yes. time was, these people are under the oppression of curses.
Yeah.
Witchcraft.
Yes.
And a very severe bondage.
Wow.
That is when now the word, break their curses.
Uh-huh. Came forth.
Yes.
Wow. Our viewers, that is wonderful. God has given the Reverend such a powerful revelation on the 21 curses that every Kenyan, and I want to say every African, everybody out there, this is a book for you to read. So stay tuned wherever you are. You're going to gain a lot of knowledge, revelation. All the curses that are in your life are going to be broken from today. My name's Joyce W. Charles. Welcome to the show. So now tell us,
right.
what is a curse?
Okay, from the perspective of the Bible,
yes.
a curse can be explained in a diverse way.
Uh-huh.
For example, when you talk about a curse,
yes.
it is the absence of blessing.
Yes.
Anytime blessings are absent, what is operating in that place is a curse.
All right.
When we talk of a curse,
yes.
it is an invisible force.
Okay.
An invisible force
yeah.
that counterattacks the goodness of God in your life.
Yes.
A curse is when others are succeeding,
uh-huh.
you are failing.
Yeah.
Where people manage things easily,
mm-hmm.
you have to struggle.
All right.
What others are able to get easily,
yeah.
you must sweat years after years.
Yes.
So that is a sign there could be a curse operating in your life.
Uh-huh.
At the same time,
yeah.
when we are talking about a curse, it is a force that can arrest you.
Yes.
Where others succeed, you fail.
Uh-huh.
What others take a shorter time to achieve, you take so many years.
Uh-huh.
A curse is when a doctor is not able to tell you your problem.
Now, the things you're saying are things that possibly people go through and they think it's natural.
Yes. Most of the people assume.
Yeah.
This is normal.
Or is a coincidence.
It's a coincidence.
Uh-huh.
My sister is not married. I'm
yeah.
not married.
Yes.
My father or my mother was not married.
Yeah.
It is a normal phenomenon.
Yeah.
But when you look at it with the spiritual eyes,
uh-huh.
you'll be able to detect something is wrong somewhere.
So in other words, what you're telling us is that we should not accommodate anything
yeah.
in our lives that doesn't look like blessing, because there is a force called curses that is operating.
Right.
Yeah.
When Jesus comes
yeah.
and he says, I have come
yeah.
that you may have life
yes.
and have it more abundantly.
Amen.
What Jesus was saying is, whatever does not look like God
uh-huh.
has no place in your life.
Yes.
So anything that does not look like God
yes.
in your life,
yeah.
you should not accommodate it.
Wow.
Because number one, Jesus came so that we may have life and have it more abundantly.
Amen.
Heart attack is not life in abundance.
Yes.
Diabetes is not life in abundance.
Exactly.
Prolonged and delayed
yes.
lifestyle before you get married.
Yes.
Is not a blessing.
Uh-huh.
So we must look at it in a way, you know, there is a problem somewhere.
Yes.
Right.
Wow, that is so powerful. And so now I want to ask, you find that mostly in our churches, whether you're a believer or not, sometimes people really don't believe in their curses.
Right.
But people will live with problems, but they are able to accommodate. So now, how do we know whether they are real? Are they there? Is it that God just wants us to live with the gray area? Are there curses or not?
Curses are real.
Yes.
If you read in Revelation 22 verse number 3.
Yes.
The writer says, and there shall be no more curse,
mm-hmm.
but the throne of God and of the Lamb shall be in it,
yes.
and his servants shall serve him.
Uh-huh.
So it's talking about the future. There yes. shall be no more curse.
Wow.
So currently, yes. that's a sign there will be there curses. There will
uh-huh.
be curses.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
So when it says there will be no more curses, that means now curses yeah. exist.
All right.
And when you look at the Bible very well, there are scriptures that we have misunderstood.
Yes.
Man is a triune.
Mm-hmm.
He is a spirit. He is. He has a soul.
Yeah.
And he lives in a body.
Yes.
So when you got born again, it is your spirit man that got born again.
Right.
Your soul didn't get born again.
Yes.
And your body didn't get born again.
Uh-huh.
So the Adamic nature.
Still there.
That was dead in sin.
Uh-huh.
That is what got born again.
All right.
And Jesus clarified and said, whatever is born of the spirit mm-hmm. is spirit.
Yeah.
What is born of the flesh yeah. is flesh.
Yes.
So my spirit man
yeah.
is born again.
Yes.
And that is why I support that with scriptures by saying,
yeah.
if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature.
Yes.
That is a spirit man.
Yes.
You are a new creature.
Uh-huh.
The old is gone.
Yes.
New has come.
Uh-huh.
You are spirit man.
Yes.
But your blood yes. is not a new creature.
Uh-huh.
Your soul is not a new creature.
Right.
So the bloodline problems are still in existence.
Wow. Wow.
So what we are dealing with yeah. is not your spirit man. He is born again.
Uh-huh.
But your blood
yeah.
is the blood of your father.
Yes.
The blood you carry is the blood of your ancestors.
Yes.
So when we are talking about curses,
mm-hmm.
we are dealing with what is in the blood.
Yes.
Yes.
No, I think the reason why believers, we struggle basically to deal with the fact that curses are there.
Yes.
Is because we have the notion, and it's actually scriptural, the Bible says that Jesus became a curse.
Right.
So how do we misinterpret that scripture? Because I think we, like you're saying, we don't really interpret scripture right.
Right.
Yeah.
Generally what happens,
yeah.
And the scriptures are clear on that.
Yes.
Jesus, number one, on the cross said, it is finished. So we must understand what he finished.
All right.
Because if what Jesus said got finished,
yeah.
number one, by his stripes,
yes.
we are and we were healed.
Uh-huh.
Does that mean we don't have hospitals?
They are there.
Hospitals are there.
Yeah.
He took away the sins of the world.
Yes.
Are there sinners?
A lot.
So that tells us,
yeah.
there are things that we need to do.
Uh-huh.
That is, we enforce the verdict of the cross.
Amen. Listen to that again. Yeah. We enforce the verdict of the cross.
Of the cross.
That's why we miss it.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Because if Jesus said it is finished and yeah. he closed the chapter, then Paul will not come and tell us, put on the whole armor.
Right.
Because Paul comes later and says,
yeah.
for we wrestle not.
So there is a battle.
Yes, there is a battle now.
And yet it was finished.
Yes, so we must understand that.
Yeah, yeah.
Paul came late after Jesus.
Yeah.
And he said a great door has been opened.
Yes.
But there are many adversaries.
Uh-huh.
I would have come to Thessalonica
yes.
once and again, but Satan
hindered
me. So
uh-huh.
which is Satan is this?
Yes.
That Jesus never dealt with him on the cross.
Right.
So that is where we misunderstanding or
yeah.
we don't understand how and yes. what Jesus dealt with.
And we actually argue about curses
yes.
and we are born again people. So now we clearly understand that curses are there. We need to really reinforce the verdict of the cross.
Of the cross.
So that what Jesus did would be effective in our lives.
Right.
It's like just saying there is an account somewhere. If you don't go to make a withdrawal, what
right.
is in there will not help you.
Very true.
Yeah.
Like somebody was in a barber shop.
Yes.
And as they were doing his hair,
uh-huh.
he was reading his Bible.
Yes.
And the man doing the haircut
yeah.
saw this guy is reading the Bible.
Yeah.
And this man said, I don't believe there is God.
Uh-huh.
And he said, why do you say so?
Yeah.
Because there is a lot of suffering, people are dying, killing,
tornadoes,
all these things.
All those yes. things, yes.
So this man did not answer.
Uh-huh.
After he had been through with his haircut, he just left.
Uh-huh.
Getting outside,
mm-hmm.
he found a man who had very shaggy hair.
Right.
Then he said, right, I've got the answer. He took that man in the Kinyozi, the barber, and he told the barber, I don't believe they are barbers.
Mm-hmm.
He said, why do you say that?
Yes.
But how come this man has this kind of hair and you have not shaved him?
Yes.
And he said, they don't come to us. Then he said, there is God. It's people who don't go to God.
Wow.
Yes.
That is such a powerful example.
Right.
So the solution is there. We need to go to God. Now, when we're discussing about the 21 curses that every Kenyan must break.
Yes.
Now, how do we Kenyans get to this? How did we enroll? Did our parents do it? Are we doing it every day? What's going on?
Okay, what generally happens?
Yeah.
Curses have different origins.
Yes.
And in my book, what I've written is the sources of curses.
Yeah, yeah.
Where curses come from,
yes,
how to diagnose a curse,
yeah,
and how to break these curses.
Uh-huh.
And the reason why, because somebody asked me, are there only 21 curses?
Uh-huh. That's a good question.
That was the revelation that prevailed that time.
Yes.
And that is the kind of problems that I saw people experiencing in our society.
Uh-huh.
And that is when God started speaking to me, that is a curse, that is a curse,
yes,
that is a curse.
Yes.
So, curses can be issued.
Mm-hmm.
We can also say a curse is an evil statement,
mm-hmm,
or an utterance,
yes,
spoken by man,
yeah,
against persons,
yeah,
places, yeah, or things.
Ah.
Yes.
All right.
So a curse can be spoken upon a person,
yes,
a place,
yeah,
or a thing.
Uh-huh. Can you maybe possibly give us an example? If somebody wants to destroy maybe my life,
yes,
what example would they say that will affect me?
For example, I can look that in the Bible, in the book of Numbers.
Yes.
Numbers 22,
mm-hmm,
from verse number 6-7.
Yes.
So a man was hired, Balaam.
Yes.
He was told, come and curse
Israel.
Israel.
Uh-huh.
So somebody can be hired, meaning come and speak evil.
Yes.
Cause these people not to progress.
Now, let us stop right there.
Yes.
We all speak.
Uh-huh.
Why is this person who is being hired? Do they have authority in what they are speaking? Uh-huh. Or what was the level of being able to curse?
Now, when this man was hired, Balaam, Balak told him,
mm-hmm,
for I know whomsoever you curse is cursed,
uh-huh,
and whoever you bless is blessed.
Yes.
And at the same time, the Bible says, death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Uh-huh.
So man was created in a way, the statements he can release for somebody or against somebody can bring good or evil.
So every tongue is powerful.
Is powerful.
Depends with the revelation you have in,
yes,
the power that you have in the tongue.
Very true.
Yeah.
Now that, now what gives the curse a power,
yeah,
is from what authority is this curse coming,
uh-huh,
from?
Uh-huh.
Parents,
yeah,
both spiritual and physical parents,
yeah,
a man of God, a prophet,
yeah,
a leader,
uh-huh,
like for example Joshua,
yes,
when they destroyed the walls of Jericho,
right,
in Joshua 6:26,
yeah,
Joshua made a statement,
mm-hmm,
cursed is the man,
yeah,
who rises to build Jericho.
Yes.
That was a curse pronounced upon a place.
Uh-huh.
And there are people who live in cursed places.
And they don't know.
They don't know. You realize if you live in a cursed place,
yeah,
poverty is rampant, sicknesses, crime rate is very high in specific areas of Kenya.
Wow.
And all over the world.
Wow.
Yes. Where poverty, people cannot afford a meal.
Yes.
And they are still comfortable.
Yeah.
You try to relocate these people to a better place,
yeah,
they still go back.
Yes.
Because they have been bound by that territorial curse.
That's very deep.
Yes. So a curse can be in a place,
yeah,
upon a person.
Yeah.
It can be in a city,
yeah,
a community,
yeah,
and even in a whole nation.
No, I just want to stop you right there. We look at Africa. I know we're talking about 21 curses about Kenyans.
Yes.
Let's talk about Africa. Looking at Africa as a continent.
Right.
We are very blessed with a lot of minerals and everything else that God created any other continent with.
Right.
But if you look at our economic system, Africa has not gone as far as the other continents have gone.
Yes.
Would you place that one to be an issue with maybe our traditions got us in a curse, idol worship? What's going on in Africa? Why do you have to go to America to look for the American dream?
What generally is happening in the African continent?
Yes.
We have a very, very dark history.
Uh-huh.
Very, very dark history.
Yeah.
Our ancestors worshipped idols.
Right.
Many communities are coming from idol worshipping communities.
Yes.
And there is what I call the curse of idol worship.
Yes, yes, yes. Absolutely.
And God Himself said,
yeah,
I am a jealousy God.
Mm-hmm.
I visit the iniquity of the fathers upon their children to the third and the fourth generation.
Yeah.
Meaning that four generation is 400 years.
A generation is 100 years?
Yes.
So are you telling me something that was done in my lineage?
Yes.
400 years ago can affect me?
It can pursue you.
Oh my God.
Yes, those are what we call traveling curses.
Yes.
Yes, they travel generationally.
Wow.
And that is why God is always specific when He introduces Himself.
Yes.
I am the God of Abraham,
uh-huh,
Isaac, and Jacob. Those
yes
are three generations.
Yes.
Yes. Whatever happens to Abraham,
yeah,
happens to Isaac,
yeah,
happens to Jacob.
Yeah.
Because he is a generational God.
Yeah.
Satan is also a generational Satan.
Yeah.
He will invade a continent like Africa,
yeah,
with generational poverty.
Uh-huh.
Generational poverty.
Yeah.
Because of idol worship.
Yeah.
Number two,
yeah,
is because of bloodshed.
So you're saying Africa, like we have a ground for yes the enemy to...
Yes.
Yeah.
The enemy is legally
yeah
in Africa.
Wow.
Because of idol worshipping.
Yeah.
Bloodshed that have been shed in Africa.
Yes.
And you know, blood or the life of a person is in his blood.
Yeah.
So people that were massacred in Africa, different countries,
yeah,
their blood speak for avenging, for wow revenge.
Yes, yes.
And that kind of a country or a nation,
yeah,
they may not suffer now,
yeah,
but the second and the third generation will pay dearly
wow
for that.
Yes.
So there is a curse of idol worship.
Uh-huh.
There is also curse of bloodshed, yes, shedding innocent blood.
Uh-huh.
The blood keeps speaking.
Yeah.
That is where you'll find in one area it is a desert.
Uh-huh.
The blood is speaking against
yeah
the community in that area.
Yes.
Thirdly,
yeah,
there are covenants
uh-huh
that we Africans entered into.
Yes.
Covenants with the dead,
uh-huh,
covenants with demons, covenants with witches,
mm-hmm,
and those covenants run throughout generations.
Yes.
And that is what is affecting nations.
Wow. So in other words, this book, even though it's written for Kenyans, whatever is inside can help anybody.
Anybody
who can look at the diagnosis of a curse and say, I think I'm suffering something.
Right.
You encourage them to read this book.
I encourage every person. The second edition of this book will
yeah
now cover everybody.
Uh-huh.
Because now most of the people, I've talked to people from Ethiopia.
Yeah.
Others are from other nations.
Yes.
They ask, are we also included
in this?
Yes. And I tell them, every believer, every
yeah
man or woman,
yeah,
whether born again
or
not,
yeah,
there are curses that keep following us
yeah
generationally.
Yes.
Like the curse of Jericho, I've
uh-huh
just mentioned.
Yes, yes.
That whoever rises to build Jericho,
yeah,
Joshua said he will put the foundation
yeah
with the death of his firstborn.
Uh-huh.
And he will put the gates with the death of his lastborn.
Mm-hmm.
700 years later.
That is not even funny.
Yeah.
700 years later.
Yes.
Oh God.
700 years later.
Yeah.
In 1 Kings 16:34.
Yeah.
A man came from Bethel.
Yeah.
A Bethlehemite.
Yeah.
He built Jericho,
mm-hmm,
overlooking the existing curse.
Yes. Because I mean, after 700 years,
yes,
you don't even maybe know whether there is something going
yeah
on there.
You just see people are living normally.
Yeah.
But this man came and provoked and violated the law that was in the land.
Yeah.
That cursed is any man who rises to build.
Yeah.
And our audience, I want to just speak to the audience.
Uh-huh.
There are communities who cannot build houses because there is a curse. The day you begin building a stone house,
yeah,
a curse strikes.
My God.
There are women who can't get married.
Yeah.
The day you get married, the husband dies. So there are men who die mysteriously and a woman becomes a widow at a very young age.
Not knowing there is something.
There is a curse in the family.
How now, let's say somebody is watching us and you're thinking, could this be the reason why I've been experiencing miscarriage after miscarriage?
Right.
Reason why I'm not able to get married.
Mm-hmm.
Now, in such a case, when somebody, realizes that they have that kind of a, background, what do they do?
For example, now,
yeah,
there are so many stories of people's lives in our services whose life changed after they had this kind of a message.
Yeah.
We'll show maybe some of the captions of women giving testimonies.
Amen, yes.
After four miscarriages.
Yeah.
And you can't explain why can a baby die in the womb, the first one, the second baby dies in the womb, the third one dies.
Yeah.
Until they came over and I realized it is a curse in the womb.
Uh-huh.
Maybe that was pronounced by a grandmother,
uh-huh,
you'll never give birth to me.
That is very common, especially.
Yes. Yeah. Or he got married to this man whose ancestors carry curses.
Mm-hmm.
So until we broke the curse,
yeah,
she conceived.
Oh my God.
And delivered safely. She has a girl of 3-4 years.
Yeah.
And this last month we prayed for her with another baby.
Wow.
The curse was totally broken.
Broken.
Yes.
So what you're telling us is that there is a solution.
There is a solution.
That is so powerful. There is a solution. It is not the end of the world. Just because you have got something going on in your life that you can tell is not God. There is a solution. Our God is a God of solution. Now,
yes,
let us talk about the curse of death.
The curse of death. That is quite in order.
Yeah, the curse of death. Sometimes we go to funerals and we hear that God gave.
God
take. Or
yes,
people just get into an accident, or people just die mysteriously.
Right.
So when is it that, when do we say God has taken, and when do we know it was really the will of God for that person to go home?
When you study the word of God in Psalms 91:16,
yeah,
17,
yeah,
God says, with long life I will
satisfy you.
Yes. Long life is not 30 years.
Uh-huh. What's long life?
When you look biblically, the years that God said, which we call them covenant years, is 120 years.
Wow, 120.
That is the covenant years.
So this business of people saying in a funeral, he was 70 years old, 60, they have done the Bible days, they can go. No. It's not biblical.
70 years was David.
David.
Yeah, he said the years of a man is 70, and if he has more strength, he has 80. But if you look at Genesis chapter number 6-7, when God said, my spirit will no longer strive with man, that is before the flood, he said, because he is flesh, yet his days shall be 120.
So that is what we should be standing with.
That those are the years I will live.
Me too.
Amen.
Me
and
too.
Also the viewers,
yes,
I cancel every death in your life.
Amen.
And your family. You will not die the way your father died.
Yes.
You cannot die the death of your friends.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen and amen.
Yes.
So the curse of death, how does it enter? Have you ever experienced something like that? How do you know it's a curse of death in your family or in your life?
Generally,
when
we talk about the curse of death, is when now you look in a family, people die prematurely.
Yeah.
People die prematurely.
Yeah.
That every month there is a funeral.
Uh-huh.
After 6 months, there is
another
funeral.
One.
A whole family is wiped in a Nissan or in an accident.
Yeah.
So when you see that kind of a scenario, it should send a signal.
Uh-huh.
Why are our people dying?
Let me just ask at that point.
Yes.
Do you think the curse of death can manifest in sicknesses that come to bring a death sentence?
Right. Okay. Number one, when we talk about sickness, what is sickness?
Uh-huh.
Sickness is a death of your health.
Yes.
Now, a curse can manifest as sickness and later mature as death.
Yes.
Yes. So death is a matured curse.
Uh-huh.
It has already graduated from sickness.
Yeah.
Now it is death.
All right.
And the curse of death comes through covenants that were established.
Yeah.
Curses that were spoken, like in the family of Eli.
Mm-hmm.
God spoke to Eli and he said, your generation will serve me.
Yeah.
But because of the sin of your sons in the temple, let it be far from that.
Yeah.
There will be no old man in your family.
Oh God.
Yeah. God announced that in the family of Eli.
Yeah.
And actually, when Israel was fighting the Philistines,
yeah,
a man came home running to tell Eli, the Ark of the Covenant is taken by the Philistines.
Yes.
Immediately he heard that, he collapsed and died.
Uh-huh.
Death struck the father.
Wow.
And when his sons were in the battle,
yeah,
Hophni and Phinehas,
yeah,
they also died in the battle.
Uh-huh.
This girl who was married
yeah
to Hophni,
yeah,
when she was delivering, she also died.
So
you can be married to a family that has already been cursed. So you will die in the process.
You enroll yourself in a curse.
Yeah, you have already enrolled in a family
yeah
who are suffering the curse of death.
Oh my God.
Look for example, but we'll be looking at them gradually.
Yeah.
This is Naomi.
Yeah.
And the husband.
Yeah.
Elimelech.
Uh-huh.
They have left the land of Moab
yeah
with their two sons.
Yeah.
They went to live in Moab.
Yeah.
After a few months or years, Elimelech died.
Yes.
After some years, these two boys marries Ruth and Orpah.
Yeah.
These two young men died, leaving two widows.
Yes.
Of Ruth and Orpah.
Yeah.
So you see now, Naomi is a widow.
Uh-huh.
Ruth is a widow.
Yes.
Orpah is a widow.
Yes.
So this is a curse that arrested men only.
Mm-hmm.
All the men.
Yeah.
Died. And that is when Naomi realized, I may die also, you let me go back home.
Yeah.
So you realize there is death that we call programmed death that will make sure that all the women in a family are widows.
Yes.
There is this curse of death also that will make sure that all the men are widowers.
Wow.
So it is a silent curse. I call it a silent curse.
Uh-huh.
But people don't detect it.
Yes.
Yes. It was either pronounced or programmed in that family.
Yes.
Or people with specific names
uh-huh
die at a certain age.
Wow.
Yes.
That is very, very deep. So in other words, what I'm getting is that when it comes to life, when you're living every day, for example, our young people out there, Papa.
Yes.
You've just met this young man in college and you want to get married to this young man or young girl.
Right.
We must be very careful.
Very careful, because you don't know whether this person is coming with a covenant of death.
A handsome guy with a package of death.
Yes.
Wow.
He looks handsome. He looks promising.
Yeah.
A girl who is looking so beautiful.
Yeah.
All that. But within a month or two after she rises into prominency with money.
Yeah.
She is killed.
Or the night before their wedding.
Yes. We have seen that happening. We have news all over.
Yeah.
People were coming from paying dowry. They all died.
Yeah.
Just recently on our television.
Yeah.
We see a bus crashing and killing more than 12 people who were coming from a barrio.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow.
So these things are hidden.
Yeah.
It takes mystery to demystify another mystery.
Yes.
Yes.
Wow. You hear that? Takes yes mystery to demystify another mystery.
Yes.
Wow.
So, like for example, when I say it takes a mystery
yeah
to demystify another mystery.
Yeah.
Biblically, we are told even if our sins are as red as crimson, they will be white as snow.
Yeah.
That tells me sin is red.
Yeah.
So for God to demystify
yeah
the sin which is red,
uh-huh,
he had to bring the blood of Jesus which is red.
Wow, wow.
Yes,
that's
to
a mystery.
Cleanse us
yeah
to be white as snow.
As snow.
Yes.
Now I think we'll do another show sometimes on that marriage issue. I think I got yeah a shock of my life because it means then there is a lot of confusion because we enroll ourselves in things we should not be enrolling ourselves into.
Yes, you've just reminded me something.
Yeah.
This man called Jeremiah.
Yeah.
God told him, before you were formed in your mother's womb,
yeah,
I knew you.
Uh-huh.
That is Jeremiah.
Yeah.
I made you a prophet to the nations.
Yes.
To uproot, to do all that.
Yeah.
Then that is Jeremiah chapter 1.
Mm-hmm.
In Jeremiah 16,
yeah.
God says, you shall not marry from this place.
Wow.
Because the people born in these families, they die prematurely.
Are you listening to that?
Yeah, that is what God told Jeremiah.
So there are places we should not marry.
There are people, unless and until their curses are broken.
Uh-huh.
The day you marry, there are people who were rich, but yeah. To me they married, they became poor.
That's very yes. common, yes.
There are those you marry,
yeah.
Your destiny is upside down. So that's... Jeremiah was warned. Anyone you will marry from this place,
yeah.
They die of grievous deaths.
Oh God.
Yes.
That calls for another show specifically on marriage, engagements, and spiritual matters, because yeah. I think most of us are suffering because we just go and meet somebody, we settle down, we start seeing problems. The right. curse of death. Have you ever experienced anything in your family that possibly you can relate to us today?
Right.
Yeah.
That one, I can say my family members
yeah.
have been victims until I came to the realization
yeah.
something was terribly wrong.
What happened?
My grandfather, yeah. that is the father to my mother,
uh-huh.
when we were still young, would visit Mashamba in uh-huh. Kinangop.
Yeah.
I was 6-7 years.
Mm-hmm.
And one day we were told Guka is dead.
Yeah.
And wondered what happened.
Yeah.
He had hanged himself.
Suicide.
Yeah, suicide. He died. We were young and we didn't know what was wrong.
Yeah.
So years
That's
later,
so sad.
Yeah.
Yeah. yeah.
My sister, the firstborn, mm-hmm. committed suicide.
That's not funny now, because yeah. you already had a grandfather who committed suicide.
Yes, so the spirit entered through the grandfather.
Yeah.
So my sister's son, the firstborn,
yeah.
he just started saying, there are people following me. People are following me.
He's hearing, yeah. seeing, or?
He was hearing voices.
Okay.
That if you don't kill yourself, we will kill you.
Oh God.
So he started running.
Yeah.
So when he went to my mother's place mm-hmm. and he was saying people are telling me to kill myself. I hear people saying if I don't kill myself, they'll kill me.
Now wait, what is that voice would you see? Is a demonic voice?
Yeah, those are demonic voice.
Okay. okay.
You see, like now here.
Yeah.
If you bring a radio tune and start searching, you'll get frequency.
You will, yeah.
You will hear.
Yeah.
So there are voices in the sky.
Yeah.
You can hear.
Yeah.
So there are people who can hear spiritually.
Yes.
The spiritual realm opens and
hear.
You can hear.
Yeah.
So before my mother ran to call neighbors
uh-huh.
to come for his rescue, they yeah. found him hanging in the house.
It was that fast?
It was twinkling of an eye.
Oh my God.
I was in Nairobi.
Yes.
I was preaching in Nairobi.
Yeah.
By the time my mother calls me, he said, so-and-so has killed himself.
So she died just because of the voices that are
the
saying,
voices,
kill yourself.
Kill yourself or we'll kill you.
That's something that is so mysterious.
Then
what happened?
We did the burial and that was over.
Yeah.
Then another cousin of mine in Nairobi was killed by mob justice.
That's still death in another way, but the same result.
Yes, result.
Uh-huh.
Then when I looked at my life
yeah.
as the only boy in my family,
yes.
As we were growing, I asked my mother, am I the only boy who
mm-hmm.
was born in this family?
Yeah.
My mom took some time before she spoke, but she shed tears.
Yeah.
And she said, no, there were other children.
Mm-hmm.
As well, are they in boarding or are they in, they went to visit Shosho?
Yeah.
She said, no.
Uh-huh.
The firstborn died.
Uh-huh.
The secondborn died.
Of what?
Thirdborn died. Those were those days that a sickness like a chicken pox.
Would
those
kill?
Those days would
yeah.
kill. Those years.
Oh God. So three siblings
they
died.
And when I was fully grown up,
yeah, yeah.
my sister, now the fourthborn, died.
Oh God.
So out of six, we remained four. I mean, out of six, we remained two.
Yeah.
My father also followed suit in 1988.
No, that's now. That should tell somebody there is something.
Yes. Then now, that is 88. 30 years down the line again, my mother now passed on this last few months
yeah,
ago.
Yeah, yeah.
So when I look at the whole family is being wiped up.
Yeah.
Wiped.
Yeah.
And I had to stand my ground and raise a red card.
Amen.
And say enough is
enough.
Otherwise I would also be in the list.
So that's
so people are enlisted in the register of death. And they are not even aware.
Oh God.
So out of all these family members,
yeah.
now we are only two.
Left.
Yes.
a family of six.
Six.
Only two are left.
Right.
So and you say the father, there is no curses.
You include the mother. It's a whole family.
It's a whole family.
And when you look the curse of Reuben,
yeah.
When now Moses want to break it, he said, let Reuben live.
Yeah.
Let his men not be few.
Yeah.
So they were reducing because of the curse.
Oh, I see.
So there is a curse of death that keep reducing people.
People.
Yes.
Ah.
Firstborn dies.
Yeah.
Secondborn dies. Mm-hmm. They can die mysteriously.
Yeah.
Some are found dead in their own apartments.
Yes.
Others, all those are now symptoms that there is death.
In the family.
In the family, and that is a curse of death.
Oh my God.
Yes.
So now, when somebody is dealing with the curse of death, how do you specifically break it in your family? What did you do?
Firstly, to mention, there are people who would say, how do I know I have this curse of death?
Yes, yes.
People who dream with the dead.
Okay.
You keep seeing the dead.
In the dream.
In the dream.
Yeah.
You keep seeing yourself in graveyards.
Yeah.
You keep dreaming yourself speaking with the dead.
Yes.
That is number one, a sign. There are covenants of death in your family.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Okay.
So generally, you need to detect and get to know there is a curse of death. I dream with my uncle who died 10 years.
Yeah.
I dream with my father who died 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And what empowers these curses is when you are doing memorial for the dead.
So you're telling us something African people do.
Yes.
They open a big door.
A door now.
Yeah.
The dead, because we have the world of the living.
Yes.
We have the world of the dead.
Yes.
And Jesus, when he resurrected, they came to look for him.
Yeah.
And Jesus asked a question. Why are you looking for the living among the dead? So there is a different. It's totally different.
There are two worlds.
There are two worlds.
Yeah.
So when you're dreaming with the dead, you are trying to merge these two worlds.
Okay.
It is not you going. It is the dead coming to you in a dream.
Yeah. Yeah.
So many a times when we do these memorial services for the dead, we are provoking the spirits of the dead.
Yes.
We are provoking them.
Yeah, because their spirits are specifically
man
the dead.
Yes. So demons take advantage.
Uh-huh.
They take advantage. They keep harassing people in their dreams.
Yes.
So you see somebody waking up, sweating the whole body, saying, I've seen my uncle who died telling me we go.
Hey.
Telling me we go. I refuse.
Back to sender.
So I pray for my viewers, wherever you're watching me, you will not be a victim of graves.
Amen.
Or death in Jesus' name.
Yes.
So it happens. I've handled those kind of cases.
Yeah.
People tell me, Pastor, I keep dreaming with my dead Shosho, my dead uncle, my father keep telling me I join him.
Yes.
So the day you say yes, you will not wake up.
Or you walk with them in the dream and
you walk, you
in
eat.
Agreement.
Yes.
Wow.
So you may not necessarily die physically, but your finances die.
Okay.
Your marriage can die.
Uh-huh.
Because death means separation.
Yes.
Yes. So you can be separated from money,
wealth,
riches, all that.
Wow. So you say that when you realize what was going on in your family, you took a red card. What
I
did
say,
you do
enough
now?
Enough is enough.
Uh-huh.
I began to do what we call spiritual mapping.
Mm-hmm.
What could have happened
that is causing this?
Yes. And how did this death enter?
Uh-huh.
Because when death enters through a firstborn, it must exit with the lastborn.
Yeah.
I being the lastborn.
That's dangerous.
I knew now I might be, and surprisingly, when I got married, the second year I wanted to commit suicide.
The devil is a liar. What
I
would we do without the oracle of God? We thank God because God rescued. So you actually now realize this thing is after you also.
Yeah, this thing is after me so much.
Yeah.
And always thinking I'm useless.
So when somebody is dealing with the powers of death, that feeling of uselessness,
why am I living for?
Yeah.
What am I living for?
Yeah.
I am useless. I am rejected. So those are now the voices speaking in you.
You don't need to live anymore.
You don't need to live. Why should you live?
Yeah.
When those kind of thoughts begin to bombard your mind,
you are not
that's when now you'd hear somebody says, I've tried suicide 3 or 4 times.
Yeah.
But it never worked.
Yeah.
So I engaged in what we call warfare.
Uh-huh.
Not intercession.
Warfare.
warfare
yeah.
to deal with these powers once and for all.
Now, sometimes, like you're saying, you started praying the prayers of warfare, engaging yes. war.
Warfare.
Now, you may not really know what happened, but
yes.
you can still fight and overcome. Is that what you're telling us?
Yes. Right. You can decide to say,
yeah.
every curse of death
uh-huh.
in my family line,
yeah.
I break it and I command you to release me.
Mm-hmm.
Release my life. Release
yes.
my family.
Yeah.
I shall escape. What killed my mother, what killed my father will not kill me.
Uh-huh.
So you are creating an environment of life.
Uh-huh.
And that is what God likes.
Because there is power in declaration.
Yes.
All right.
And Jesus also, when teaching on the Lord's Prayer, we call it Lord's Prayer, but
yeah.
it's a disciple's prayer.
Yeah.
He said in the end, when you pray, you say, deliver us from the evil one.
Mm-hmm.
So there is an evil one.
Wow.
Yes. So I started fighting the evil one
yeah.
who killed my brothers,
uh-huh.
whom I didn't see.
Yeah.
Killed my sisters whom I never saw.
Yeah.
And my father, when now I finished form four, I want to get employed. That is when he died.
Oh,
and
God.
He died a miserable death.
Yes.
He died in the house.
Oh.
Surprisingly,
yeah.
my father died in the house.
Mm-hmm.
My mother also died in the house.
And your sister hanged herself?
In the house.
The house.
Yes.
I mean, most of the time people commit suicide in the house.
Yes. So you
oh,
see, my
God.
Father died
yeah.
right on the bed. We found him dead in the morning.
Yeah.
My mother also, a few months ago, also
yeah.
died in the house.
Yes.
Yes.
Wow.
So it is a power that caged.
Yes.
And made sure that my family members.
Yes.
They are oppressed by this
by
spirit
death.
Of death.
Uh-huh.
So I began praying what I normally call abnormal prayers.
Abnormal prayers.
Abnormal prayers.
Uh-huh.
That every altar of death.
Yeah.
Every altar of death calling my name,
yeah.
I silence you.
Uh-huh.
Because those are altars of death.
But can everybody pray that? Or is it a pastor only who can pray that?
You can pray.
Uh-huh.
You can pray that prayer.
All right.
And especially our viewers, when you realize
yeah.
in your family people die prematurely, you can be the David of your family.
Amen.
What killed your mother should not kill you.
Yeah.
What killed your brother should not kill you. You raise a red flag.
Mm-hmm.
Every curse of death, altars of death, that are speaking in my life, I silence you in Jesus' name.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
So now, looking at your life today and what God has done for you, I just imagine all the destinies that the enemy has destroyed by death. So, actually what the enemy is stopping is the destinies of great people.
Right.
So, I mean, destinies of great people, destinies and things that would have been done by these people, but they are all cut short.
They are buried. Actually.
Yeah.
All the people who are in the grave,
mm-hmm.
they didn't die. They were killed.
By who?
By sickness.
uh-huh.
Which manifested as sickness, but it killed them.
Yeah.
Accidents. People who are supposed to live to 90 years,
yeah.
they die at 45.
Oh, God.
They die at 30,
yeah.
at 60.
Yeah.
Yes. Not reaching a level where you're fulfilled. Your
in
destiny.
Life, and
yeah,
you have done
yeah.
what God wanted you to
wanted
do.
You to do.
And whatever God has put in you has come out and has manifested
yes.
in fullness.
Supposing
yeah.
I died.
Yeah, look at that.
You'll not have the Oracle Television
you
Network.
Wouldn't.
Yes.
Yeah.
If I never stopped that death flowing,
yeah.
we'll not have this Oracle Television Network.
Wow.
Yes.
When a small baby is dying,
mm-hmm.
we always say that God loved them more. What do you think
that
is?
That is a lie of the devil.
I mean, 2 years, 1 month.
Yes.
And we all spiritualize it that God loved them more.
We say we loved him, but
yes.
God loved him more.
More.
So if I have given you this laptop,
uh-huh.
I've given you because I love you.
Yeah.
And because I love you more, I take it back. That's not how God works.
Uh-huh.
When God gives you something, he
yes.
is blessing you.
All
he will
right.
be happy you using it for his own glory.
He won't take it.
He will not take it.
Yeah.
So it's not that God has given, God has taken.
Yeah.
It is God has given, but evil powers in
have
the bloodline have taken.
And then, I mean, when you look at death and all the consequences, like when your father died.
Yes.
It must have been very hard for your mom to, all the years of widowhood and bringing you
yeah.
and your sister alone.
Right.
Without a man figure to provide for her.
Right.
So there is no way you can say that God loved that person more.
No.
To let this woman suffer. I don't think that is God.
That is that. Those are just religious, I call them religious enchantments. People
uh-huh.
say, well, you can't say God has given, God has taken a baby of 1 month.
Yeah.
Yes. How cruel is this God?
It is not.
He must be a very cruel, selfish God.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can't give and take it.
Yes.
Yes, just like we prepare supper here and I serve you. And before you wash your hands, I take it back. I say, I love you so much, you can't eat this food. That is wickedness.
It's because we are failing as believers and people who speak the word. Are we failing because we're not really telling people how they should take their position of authority?
Hosea 4:6.
Yeah.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. That alone.
Yeah.
Knowledge is what empowers somebody to understand God.
Yes.
So because we cannot be dying, killing or dying, and others are being killed, and we say God has given. God has taken.
Now we have a minute. When death enters in the family, basically it's like a door of death has opened. So do we close it? Do we need to do any prophetic prayers or just warfare? Do we need to do anything more than warfare?
Maybe in the next show we'll look at some of the instrument to silence death.
All right.
Yes, because there is a way you can silence death.
Yeah.
Because I cannot pray against death, and I have the photograph of my mother hanging behind me.
Oh.
She's already dead, or my brothers are dead, but I put on their clothes, or I have their photographs in my house.
Now you're worrying us.
Yes.
Because you know now my mind is going back to all the gifts we keep because we got from.
Let me surprise you.
Yeah.
The woman with an issue of blood said, if I may touch his garment, I'll be made whole. And when she touched, Jesus said, I felt virtue. So your clothes, they can transmit virtue.
Wow.
So if I put on the clothes of a dead person, I am transferring their virtues to myself. So when you're putting clothes of the dead, you are transferring the virtues of the dead into your life.
Hold it right there. We are going on a short break. We are coming back because that is just worrying to me. To understand that there are things we have in our houses, in our possession, that could be the contact point of us to just open the doors of death in our lives.
Right.
We are coming back to you. God bless you. Don't change the channel. Keep it Oracle TV. Thank you.